Hi kids, how are you all? I hope you all must be fine. Yes. So today we are going to read for class 5 science olympiad. Okay. And in this for this preparation, what we are going to read? Which chapter? That is animals, and it is the part 2. In the part 1, we have discussed many questions, and here now we are going to discuss some more questions. Okay. So are you all ready for it? Yes. Okay, so let's start. So our first question is, which of the following animals and their respiratory organs are paired correctly? So here, which of the following animals and the respiratory organs, these are paired correctly. So here, whose animals? Parrot. Function, that respiratory organ, it is given lungs. Then fish, gills. Earthworm, skin, and cockroach gills. So what do you think? What is the correct answer? Yes. If you know the answer, then you can write in the chat box. Okay. So, means you can comment it, right? Okay. So what is the correct answer here? See. Parrot, yes, they breathe through lungs. Fish, they breathe through gills. And earthworm, they breathe through skin. But cockroach, they do not breathe through gills, right? Why? Because they breathe through the tiny pores present in their body, which is known as spiracles. Okay, so they breathe through spiracles. Got it? Yes. So here the correct answer is 1, 2 and 3 are correct. That is option D. Got it, everyone? Yes. Next question is, the figure shows an animal. Which of the following animals breathes the same way as the animal shown? So you know what is this animal, right? This is fish. So we have prawn, caterpillar, whale and worm. And it is asked that which of the following breathes the same way as this fish. Okay. So what is the answer? Yes. It is prawn. Why? Because a prawn, it also lives in water, right? And it takes the dissolved oxygen which is present in water and it breathes through gills. But this caterpillar, whale, worm, they do not do that, right? That's why correct answer is option A, that is prawn. Okay. Next is, penguins live in polar regions. So it is given that penguins, they live in polar regions. Okay. Which adaptation enable them to survive? So, what adaptation do penguin so that it can survive? And options are, which one, they have a layer of fat under their skin. Two, they have webbed feet. Three, they migrate to warmer climates during winter. So, what do you think? What is the answer? Yes. So the answer is, they have a layer of fat under their skin. Yes, it is true. So it enables them to survive in winter. Yes. Then they have webbed feet. Yes, it is also true. So here, what is the correct answer? The correct answer is option A, only 1 in 2. Yes. Okay, so let's move to the next question. So what is the question here? Look at the figure below. It has few predators because of its A, big feet, B, small eyes, C, hard shell, D, large mouth. So this it has few predators. Okay, so why tortoise has few predators? Because there is something which helps it from the predators, means help to protect it from the predators, right? And what is that structure? Yes. You can guess it, right? It is hard shell. The hard shell of tortoise, it helps us to protect it from the predators, right? Yes. So let's move to the next question. So here, which of the following uses its legs as oars? Prawn, tadpole, water boatman, moth. So which of the following uses its legs as oars? So what happens here? Which of them has legs as oars? So prawn, tadpole, water boatman, moth. Prawn, tadpole, moth, you know, right? And what is this water boatman? Do you have any idea, anyone? So it is an insect. Okay, so water boatman, it is an insect. And it is the correct answer. It uses its legs as oars. Right? Okay. Next is, the hump of a camel helps in storing. Option A, water. B, hump chewed grass. C, fat. D, blood. So, you have seen the hump of a camel? Yes. So, where have you seen the camel? Yes. Have you ever been to desert or what? No. Right. So, the hump of a camel, it helps in storing. What do you think? What does it store? Yes. That hump, that is due to fat. It stores the fat. Okay. So, the next question, that is, birds can fly due to light body weight. This is due to option A, hard bones, B, soft bones, C, cylindrical bones, D, hollow bones. So, birds, they can fly. We know birds can fly, right? It is due to their light body weight. So, why they are having light body weight? That is the question, right? So, the correct answer is option D, that is hollow bones. So, their bones are hollow. So, their body weight, that is less, and that's why they can fly. Got it? Yes. Next question is, which of the following statements about animals are true? 1. Amphibians are the only group of animals without any outer covering of their skin. 2. Birds are the only group of animals with an outer body covering of feathers. 3. Fish are the only group of animals with an outer covering of scales. 4. Mammals are the only group of animals with an outer body covering of hair and suckle their young. Okay. So, what is the correct answer? Yes. See, the amphibians and the amphibians and earthworm, they have moist skin. Okay, and about the fish and fish and snakes, they have scales. Okay, so here the correct answer is 2 and 4. Birds are the only group of animals with an outer body covering of feathers, and mammals are the only group of animals with an outer body covering of hair and suckle their young. Right, so correct answer is that is option B. Okay, option B, 2 and 4 only. Okay, next is, read the information about an animal X in the box given below. Animal X eats plant parts. Okay, so what it is given? Animal X, it eats plant parts. It gives birth to young ones and feed them with milk. Okay, so identify the animal X. A, fox. Option B, goat. C, tiger. D, lion. What do you think? If animal X eats only plant parts, so what it may be? Is it fox, tiger or lion? No. It gives birth to young ones and feed them with milk. So what is the correct answer? Yes. Very good everyone. You must be knowing, right? So it is the B, that is goat. Okay. Next, camels have thick leathery pad under their heels. This helps them. Option A, walk in hot sand. B, swim easily. C, climb steep slopes. D, none of these. So, we know that camels, they have thick leathery pad under their heels. So, why do they have them? Yes, but do you think why do they have them? They have them so that they can means adapt something, right? For adaptation, they are doing these things. So, what is the requirement? Why they are doing this? We know the camels, they are present in desert, right? And it is very hot. So, hot sand is there. So, how will they work on the hot sand? Yes, they can't wear the slipper or the shoes, right? So, it is natural. So, they have thick and leathery pad, right? Yes, inbuilt shoes, we can say. So, here the correct answer is option A, that is work in hot sand. Yes, got it? Next, the figure shows an animal how does the animal protect itself from extreme weather conditions? So what do you think? Option A, it undergoes hibernation. B, it has a very thick of covers. Then it migrates to warmer place. D, it has folded skin. So what may be the answer? Yes. Yes, in extreme weather condition, it migrates to the warmer place. Okay. Yes. Next is, the animals given below are similar in some way. Name the feature common to all of these. So, snail, crab and prawn. So, what is the common feature present in all of these? Can you answer? If you know, you can write in the comment box. Yes. Yes, you all must be knowing, right? The correct option is option C, sails. So, sails, it is a feature which is present in case of snails, crabs and of course in the prawn. Yes. Next, P feeds on Q. P feeds on Q, R and S. Okay. So, here P, it feeds on Q, R and S. And Q and S, they only feed on R. R is one of the natural earth resources. So, R, it is one of the natural earth resources. Okay. So, what is that P? Q, R, S, whatever. Right. So, R is a natural earth resource. And so, we can say that these are plants. Okay, next is about Q and S. Q and S, they are consuming plants. So, we can say these are herbivores. Okay, and P, it is consuming Q, R, S. So, we can say that P, these are omnivores. Right? So, which is most probably true of the following? Option A, P is an omnivore. Is P omnivore? Yes, we found it, right? P is omnivore. Okay. R is herbivore. No, R, that is plant. S is omnivore. No, S is herbivore. We found it, right? D, Q is carnivore. No, Q is also herbivore. So, here what is the correct answer? Correct answer is option A, that is P is omnivore. Okay. Yes. So, make the following terms in column 1. With their examples in column 2. Okay, so aquatic, terrestrial, aerial, arboreal. These are present in column 1. And in column 2, trees, air, water and land. So, what is the correct answer? Yes, aquatic means, yes, they live in water, right? And what do you mean by terrestrial? They live in land. Aerial, they live in air, okay, and arboreal, they live in trees, right? So, P3, where it is? Did you forget? Yes, I got it. So, it is in option A. P3, Q4, R2 and S1, okay? Yes. Next, why are scales important to fish? We know fish have scales, right? So, why do fish have scales? Option A, it helps the fish in swimming. B, it helps the fish in finding direction. C, it helps the fish in maintaining its direction. Okay. D, it helps in protecting the fish. So, what do you think? Why scales are there? Yes, they help in protecting the fish. Okay. So, here the correct answer is option D. Got it, everyone? Yes. Okay. So, this much for today's class, right? So, let's meet you in the next class. Then, till then, read mindfully, okay? And bye-bye everyone. Bye-bye.